Everybody's doing something. We'll do nothing.
I think I might be able to help with the Pam dilemma.
The price is wrong, bitch.
Wait, let me explain something to you.
I am loving.
Mama says that alligators are ornery because they got all them teeth but no toothbrush.
That frog really tied the room together, did it not?
You are a smelly pirate hook.
That guy in little coat.
Happy Cinco de Mayo to our friendly neighbors down southern of the border, Mexico.
Yeah. Except
we love you. We are international. We have been international. Surprise, surprise, surprise. We've chatted with the locals.
Our YouTube channel analytics say that we are an international show. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's see right now. Hold on. I'll tell you
from
right
Mexico.
Now. Live update. Here's a live update of our YouTube channel geography.
I know we got Canada. Canada crossed international. Hold any on. Mexico. Gotta have
tell you right
one.
Now.
Listen, profits are up 1,000%. Okay, last week we're at 1. This week we're at 2.
Okay, you ready for this?
Yeah.
Our top one is the United States.
Shout out.
Big whopping 30% of our viewers.
Oh, yeah. USA.
Rock flag and eagle.
Rock flag and eagle. That's okay, one for the home team.
Our second one is Brazil.
Oh, yeah. They got to celebrate Cinco de Mayo, right?
Yeah, 5% of our viewers, Brazil.
Nice.
You ready? Number three, Mexico.
Mexico.
Sitting at a 4% of our viewers.
Oh, let's go. Look at that. Look at that. Mr. Worldwide. Mr. 802.
Next one, Philippines. The Philippines. That's pretty sweet. Then the United Kingdom. Then Russia. Nice. And then Canada.
Look at us. Look at us.
Japan, Thailand, India.
Full range. Full range.
Worldwide.
Worldwide. Prestige.
How you doing?
Worldwide.
Right up at ya.
Right up at you. This was a huge weekend. For starters, number one, I am sunburnt to shit, so I am licking my wounds right now. I have a racing stripe. Look at this racing stripe on my head.
Oh my God. Dude. I'm fucking, look at my face. I just came in from a run. My face looks like a fucking cherry balloon.
I'm wearing sleeves right now, so you don't see how red my arms are. And the worst part is, when we were golfing yesterday, I looked at Cody and go, you think we should throw sunscreen on? And he goes, I don't think it's that strong. His wrist, he has a band from where his watch was.
Yeah, famous last words. Yeah. I don't think it's that strong.
I looked to him. I'm like, it was maybe hole 7. I go, it's feeling like a little sunny out. You think we should throw some on? He goes, I don't think it's that strong. I come into the house. I have a fucking racing stripe on
next
my forehead.
You know, your fucking lobster salad.
Dude, exactly. Heat is coming off my fucking skin. I look like Kramer when he got torched with the butter.
Stick a fork in me, Jerry. I'm done.
What an episode. But yeah, this was a huge weekend. Cinco de Mayo, Friday. Okay. You got Derby, Saturday.
Yeah.
What were you going to say?
There's a lot of sports on, right?
So many. I watched the NLL playoffs. That was the coolest thing ever.
Yeah.
Did you ever get
NLL
to
playoffs, NBA playoffs, NHL playoffs?
Yeah, LeBron. And the Lakers.
Can we just, like, we don't do a lot of hockey because of the Spit and Chicklets guys. We really like them.
They do a great job, like, covering for us.
But what about the Florida Panthers, man? These guys are just fucking on fire.
Did you watch the Edmonton game last night?
No.
All right. So I turned it on when it was 5-0, like halfway through the second. It was a bloodbath from here on out. It was line brawl after line brawl after line brawl. It was awesome. Well,
Edmonton, I mean, they had to do something. They're down 2-0, right? Like,
they're winning right now against Vegas. They're up 2-0.
Really? I
thought maybe Vegas 1-1. Might be 1-1 now.
Oh.
So this was the second game. I thought Vegas
won the first two.
No, just one. They definitely won the first one. But it was a bloodbath. There, Kane was punching a guy when he was down on the ground, so he got an extra, 2 minutes.
Yeah.
The goalies were getting into it. And then in the NLL championships, those were sick. That's a bloodbath. You want to talk about gladiators. Those guys are fucked.
That's one level fighting up from hockey. It's that's so aggressive, the NLL.
Dude, the vicious cross checks that they just let go in that sport.
Yeah.
They're setting picks like NFL blitz. Yeah. It's literally
everybody's out here talking about
it's like the NFL
floor is who the toughest athlete is, and I'm telling you right now, it's indoor lacrosse. People don't understand.
How about
to play indoor lacrosse is you're just, it's basically a fucking war.
Yeah,
it's just an absolute war.
I mean, it looks like NFL blitz, how you can just blindside guys. you know, like NHL hits where you could just blindside guys.
Yeah,
and without the puck, that's the game. That's how they set picks. It was sick though. It was it was tied, and then Buffalo hung 20 on this team. It was over. Yeah. Everyone was scoring. It was unbelievable. They're diving across the crease, landing on AstroTurf with nothing on their legs.
Yeah, indoor painful lacrosse, that is. And they play music throughout the game.
Dude, it's like a nightclub with a vicious sport going on.
There's a vicious game going on.
And anybody near the boards gets teed up. They just lay the most, gutless, hits. 2 inches away from the boards, the guy, throws his whole body weight into you to just, these guys get rocked. There was a ground ball in the corner, and it was just a street fight for 20 minutes.
Dude,
you ever seen semi-pro when he's like, everybody hit somebody? They just start fighting.
Somebody hit somebody!
Oh, here we go.
What? Made myself a couple of hot and ready.
Look at that. Hot and ready.
Threw in a couple of White Castles.
I can't wait.
The devil.
How many White Castle burgers do you think we'll eat that whole time out there? Over under. I could suck down 20. Oh my
god, we should keep tally when we're there and see if we're right. Okay, what Always do you think?
Always Sunny with a t-shirt. Just
mark it. Yeah, exactly, with a tally.
I bet I eat 20 sliders. Because I'm gonna want a sample. I'm gonna want to sample some.
20 sliders in 2 days.
Yeah, because I'm gonna have some of the onion rings. I'm gonna have just sampling. 20 seems generous though. How many do they do at the end of White Castle the movie? 50.
We should find out.
I hope when they pick us up, you know how they have like some cars will be fancy. They have the mini fridge where you have the sparkling water, but they have sliders ready for you. ready to go.
I'm not sure if it's going to be that fancy.
We could be looking at an Uber XL.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not sure what we're walking into here. But they are delicious. Okay, so you think in 2 days.
Well, Monday, 24 hours.
In 24 hours. You think how many 20 sliders?
Well, you should do 24 hours, 24 sliders. Like a challenge.
Yeah. 25. I think I'm going to eat 25 sliders.
25 sliders.
In 24 hours. Yeah.
All right.
A slider an hour.
Slider an hour. I like it. You won't be able to do.
If we make ourselves some to bring in the airport and eat with us, do those count as the counter, or do we
the whole time when you're sucking sliders down? When you are sucking sliders down, the clock starts.
Because here's the thing: before I go to the airport, I'll make myself a few, right?
Yeah, 100%.
I'll
start breakfast off. Start the counter. We'll film
here's
it.
The thing: when we talk about one slider an hour, that doesn't seem that unreasonable.
I eat six of those little fucking things every time I go up to the microwave.
Yeah, we should try to do that.
I like it. 24 sliders.
24 sliders.
Is that like a 50th anniversary? 50 sliders.
I don't think we can do 50 sliders. That's getting
crazy. You think 24 is a lot?
Isn't that much if we legitimately do one an hour, right?
But you're going to be sleeping some of those hours, so you got to make up some time.
Yeah, so like before you go to sleep,
you gotta eat four,
and then when you wake up, you gotta eat four more to account for the 8 hours of sleep.
That's not bad. Two bags. I love two bags. After like a 2 a.m. trip, I would have like the whole box.
Absolutely. But this will be funny. We should like make a video of it.
Oh yeah. We'll get Cody involved. He's gotta join.
Yeah, I mean Cody's 20, part of the whole trip. So
24
Cody's
sliders.
Gonna be doing a lot of filming for us.
Oh yeah, he said that's what he wants to do.
Because we're gonna need.
He said he'll wear a black suit and just be. I'll just be the camera guy.
Yeah.
I was like, you don't have to do it. You don't want to, but he said he wants to. So we'll have him film our 24-hour documentary of the 24 sliders. Road to the Hall of Fame, 24 sliders, 24 hours till the award ceremony. That's what we should do. We do a 24-hour clock till the award ceremony, and we have to have 24 sliders in our stomachs.
Before the ceremony?
Before we get the award, we have to do 24 sliders, and we can talk about it at the award, and we can film ourselves eating it on stage.
The last two.
We pull out two. We cook two sliders in the hotel. We keep them with us in like a plastic bag so it keeps the heat in, and we pull a slider out, and we hammer it right on stage.
Right.
No matter how cold it is.
It's not going to be great.
Well, yeah, that thing's going to be sitting in the inside of my coat pocket, squished.
Yeah.
They will eat that shit up.
No, I mean, I think it'll be great. I'm excited.
And then we send them the footage because then they'll post that stuff everywhere.
Yeah. No, I mean, I think it's going to be a lot of fun.
That's what we're going to do. 24 sliders, 24 hours leading up to the ceremony.
Yeah, we should poll it with our audience of 5 people. Do you think we'll eat more or less than 24 and 24?
Because we can have a counter in the corner of the video where it's just the burger and then a number over the top of it. And it just keeps cycling. Exactly. Like when we're walking through the fucking the factory and we're just eating them as we're walking through.
Yeah.
Like 6. Boop.
Beer me, baby.
You're 40 beers back, bitch. Just sit back and enjoy the show.
Not poking fun at a horrific incident that happened in American history. But did you hear that there's some fan wrote a Seinfeld episode about 9/11? Have you heard?
Oh my
have you
God.
Seen this? So you know how Seinfeld ended in 98, right before the 9/11 incident. So how the plot goes is 9/11 happens. Jerry's freaking out because there's dust everywhere and he's a neat freak. So he like can't get the dust out. dust is everywhere because when the towers fell, all that dust flew everywhere. Kramer is upset because he lent one of the hijackers his box cutter, and the hijacker used it to hijack the plane, and he's like trying to get his box cutter back, so he's going to like small claims court. Elaine was dating a guy who was working at the World Trade Center, and she wanted to break it off with him, so she thinks that he died in the World Trade Center, so she's kind of happy because she doesn't have to break it off, but it turns out the guy survived, so she's like really upset.
Yeah, so who wrote that? Because that's
no idea. Pretty accurate though.
That's crazy. That's probably,
that's what would happen. That's exactly.
That's a bold move, kind of keep doing that.
Yeah, it's a bold move, Cotton.
Usually you pay double for that kind of action, Cotton.
So there's this new crypto coin called PP. P-E-P-E.
Okay.
So obviously, it's PP. So obviously the internet.
PP over Pepe.
I don't know. But obviously the internet has run with this shit coin, right?
Yeah.
So if you put $27 in 21 days ago, you know how much your shitcoin of PP is worth right now? $8 million. Everyone's buying it. Everyone's loving the meme. You know how like meme coins take over and people just start buying it? Yeah, so PP, if you put $27 in 21 days ago and you held, you would have $8 million. You'd be sitting on $8 million because everybody in the world bought a little share of PP. How fucking awesome. I love, the internet's undefeated. I love the internet.
Yeah, it's crazy now, like, how the internet can swing things.
Like Dogecoin, people took off because it was just a dog. The logo. Dog. Right. And Elon kept making funny quotes about, like, 420... 69 420. like I just, it's, and now PP's taking off. And then some stuff I've seen on the internet kind of around the horn, little weekend update for everybody.
Yeah.
There was a scenario, it might have been a prom or a wedding. So it's the guy, they're all dressed up nice. It's kind of like, looks very formal. So it looks kind of like a prom.
This would haunt me the rest of my life if I were the DJ.
So the DJ plays a song. And have you ever heard the song Thinking Out Loud by Ed Sheeran?
No. All right, I mean, so probably heard it before.
So, it's that slow song where it's like, so the girl's in a wheelchair, right?
When your legs don't work like they used to before.
Oh my god.
The crowd starts booing.
Oh my god, the crowd starts booing?
Yeah.
That is crazy. That DJ probably got.
This is a popular wedding song though. That's the fucked up part. Like that song is
obviously, but like if the girl's in a wheelchair, maybe fucking
this jam just comes on.
When your legs don't work like they used to before. That's so terrible. And I can't sweep you off of your
feet. Just so gutless.
Yeah, like, oh, buddy.
The crowd started booing. They did not think it was funny.
Yeah, that's fucking crap.
They did was funny. And then the other thing I've been noticing a lot of, I've never seen before. Have you ever heard of a putt check?
No, what's that?
It's like mini golf, but on steroids.
Yeah, we put a cool twist on mini golf. So there's a technology in the ball. There's a microchip that tracks your score for you.
Yes, I've
like
been
glow in the dark. You've been to one?
Yeah.
How awesome was it?
It's pretty fun.
Mini golf's back. You have a putt shack. Mini golf. That looks sick.
Yeah,
And have you seen Tiger Woods' new thing where it's like a miniature golf course, but it's for mini golf?
Excited to bring Pop Stroke to your backyard.
Golf's back. Mini Pop golf Stroke. Pop Stroke. You got the putt. The putt stroke, the putt shack. And my thing, my question to you is, are you big enough of a hardo where you bring your own putter?
I don't know.
What fence are you sitting on for bringing your own putter to mini golf?
I mean,
own putter.
You're starting to kill the spirit of the thing.
Like, own putter, own ball.
Yeah. Oh my god. Bringing your own ball—that's bold.
Own putter, own ball. First date.
Too many golf.
First date.
Just not messing around. I'm here for the course record.
I'm here to win.
I'm here for the course record.
Where do you draw the line? Bringing your own putter?
Bringing your own putter. That's where you draw the line.
Just use right the there. Plastic piece of shit putter.
Just use what they got, guy. What are you doing?
I have seen own putters out there.
I mean, if you got to win mini golf that bad, I'm not quite sure like what's going on with you. You know,
if you want to win that
bad. It's one thing to be competitive. It's another thing to like.
If you want to win that badly, you can have it.
You can have it, guys.
You bringing your own putter, you can have it.
Let me let you in on a little secret. I'm not really here for the mini golf. I'm here for the hangout.
Something tells me you're going to count my strokes.
Yeah. Something tells me you're going to add on for me dropping this ball.
You're going to take these hazards
four.
That's a
four.
A little too seriously.
Okay.
How about on the Big Lebowski? I watched that whole thing this weekend working out. When he's talking about the pedophile and bowling, he's like, when the guy's like, "You ever pull that shit against me?" He goes, "I pulled it." Yeah. He goes, and then his comment, 8-year-olds, dude.
8-year-olds, yeah. No,
crushes them. 8-year-olds, yeah. Dude.
Yeah. I don't roll on Sundays.
Who's the scheduler?
I don't roll on Sundays.
I'd say we got about at least 80,000 left. He goes, "No,
we're
Walter.
The cops, dude. Put the piece away.
I'm not buying it a beer, dude. It's not taking your turn, dude. It's a show dog. It's got papers."
Oh, yeah. That's probably one of the greatest
things. You brought a dog to a bowling alley? I'm not buying it a beer, dude. It's not taking your turn. I'm not renting it shoes.
Not taking your turn.
It's not taking your turn. I'm not buying it a beer. It's a show dog. It's a show dog. It's got paper. I love when you start smashing that Ferrari in the driveway. I love when he starts smashing the Maserati or whatever, that sports car, in the driveway.
Yeah.
And the next day he's on the phone with him. He goes, "No, Walter, it did not look like he was going to crack."
Oh, yeah.
They go to the burger shack. Oh, my God. Walter, when he's... when they're spreading the ashes and he starts rambling off about Vietnam. He's like, "You took on Treetop Hill, you took those young men's lives. Why'd you have the Vietnam stuff?"
With the Vietnam stuff, man. And then the ashes blow right back into his face.
I love when they're looking through the book and he's like, it's about $180. He just closes the book and just hands it back to him. What other alternatives do you have? They have a Folgers coffee can.
Yeah.
Oh, I'd also, while we're here, I'd like to take a moment of silence for American Eagle. What a run. What a run did they have from like 2000. No, no, nothing like that. It's just, you have to be completely white trash to wear that stuff nowadays. Like every white trash person rocking American Eagle.
Yeah. I mean, I don't
like,
that was
10 years ago.
Yeah. That
those polos, American Eagle polos, every True Life, every reality TV show, you will see American Eagle, Abercrombie, Hollister everywhere.
Yeah, that was like the thing for a minute, right?
And now you're the biggest tit if you wear it.
Yeah, it's not. It's weird how fast you have
a life career at a gas station and you hammer cigarettes.
Yeah. No, it's odd that American Eagle.
Just.
I think they're
like,
probably. Yeah, I think they're still in outlets.
I see them. All right. Empty. You know what's really nice? What's really turned around? Old Navy.
Oh, yeah.
Old Navy has unreal stuff.
Pretty good.
Candy of the week. This is a segment, if you haven't been following along or you're not one of the four listeners, where Jesse and I scour high and low for some of the greatest finds, rarest treats, or just the brand new candy that or snack that could be coming out. So nice. I found some pretty awesome ones this week. It's tough. This segment's hard because when I find this thing and it's like 4 days before we're about to film, I either eat it before. Yeah, it's like the willpower to not eat these snacks is next level. So I'm pretty proud of myself. But who you want to go first?
I mean, we have a dual one. You want to do that one first?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right.
So this is it's actually coincidental that Justin and I both found this. A little tangy chip Dorito.
Tangy ketchup.
And I actually, this was one of the snacks that I did get into. I bought two bags of these.
I have not gotten it. I am excited to try.
I'm excited to see what your pick is because I know I love this.
Okay, here we go.
Tastes just like ketchup chips, baby.
Wow, they're really good.
They're unreal.
I do love it. They're just the right amount of tangy. You know what I mean?
They need to keep these.
This should be in the lineup.
More people need to get on board with this. Because these are delicious. These could be better than regular ketchup chips.
Absolutely. I'm giving these like a 9.6. These are really good.
Another
level of sweet, tangy crunch.
Does have a little zing at the end with the spice. But the initial ketchup chip flavor, unbelievable.
Well, here's the thing. I hate spicy stuff, and this isn't uncomfortable for me. It's not uncomfortable.
Very doable. Very manageable.
That should be your gauge of how spicy it is. I hate spicy stuff, and this isn't that bad for me at all.
No.
So.
What are you going to score it?
9.6.
That's fair. I give it a 9.6, too.
Can you imagine if we had these when we were 12?
Even better. We got them when we're 40.
This is called Rap Snacks Icon. Snoop Dogg.
Dog.
So this is called OG Barbecue Cheddar. Okay.
That's probably going to taste really good.
Stay focused and be relentless. Rap Snacks Icon, Snoop Dogg. I'm excited.
Thank you, Snoop Dogg.
I am excited. These are new. I think I've never seen these. And
I like the artwork.
Cheddar. Yeah, barbecue cheddar is like kind of a new flavor. All right.
Delicious so flavor.
Looks like your
typical BBQ.
Yeah, good looking potato chip. Smell is good. Okay. So, at first you get the barbecue, and then on the back end the cheddar comes in. It's really good. It tastes very cheesy, right? So, no, I like them. I could probably crush a bag of these. So, I would say 9.1.
Heyo.
Snoop Dogg, 9.1.
Snoop. Snoop-a-loop. Bring your green hat.
Delicious. Delicious. The flavor is really good.
I like it. All right. I guess we'll keep it in the chip family. I got another chip here. Limited right. time flavor. Lay's coming out with another one. We got BLT sandwich.
Oh
the
my
BLT
God.
Sandwich from Lay's. So
that's crazy.
I'm excited. I can only imagine what this will taste like.
Yeah.
I bet you bacony. I bet you kind of
bacon. Definitely bacon, but how do you get the sandwich paste in there, right?
Yeah, how do you add the mayo and the lettuce?
Yeah.
Wow. Definitely bacony.
Yeah.
Heavy dose of bacon. I'm excited. Let's dive right in. Maybe oregano? Throw a little oregano in here. Wow. Okay, that's weirdly like a BLT. That's kind of crazy.
Did they get the sandwich part of it?
I got the sandwich part down. That tastes like a BLT.
That's crazy.
Which is really possible? Fucking weird because my head's thinking BLT, but my tongue feels chip.
Like, can you taste the tomato?
Well, this is how I would make the BLT. It's more bacon, lettuce, and bread.
Yeah.
So it tastes like, almost like a little bit of a turkey bacon.
Yeah.
It's fucking weird. It's really
is it good?
Like, it's good, but it's fucking with my head a little bit.
Yeah.
Like it shouldn't be a sandwich. I'm like eating a chip, but I'm thinking a sandwich.
Right.
You gotta try this.
Yeah, I mean, I'm in Atlanta, so.
BLT. They gotta have these everywhere in Atlanta, I bet.
Maybe. I gotta go check the store.
I think I give it a 9.2.
Because
I love BLTs, so this just feels like I'm eating a sandwich.
Yeah. All right, I got another one that's a chip. This company has come on strong. Takis is everywhere now, right?
Oh yeah.
And this is their new flavor, Intense Nacho, non-spicy. It says non-spicy on the back.
What we like to hear.
Intense Nacho, non-spicy. I'm excited for this.
I love anything cheese.
Yeah, and Takis are good.
Oh, I even eat the spicy ones. I suck it up, but it is.
I love the shape. I love the crunch, right? Smells pretty good. Here we go.
That looks really good.
Oh, my God. Oh, Sam, these are dangerous. I could crush about 50 bags of these. It's like the flavor is so good. It is. It's really cheesy with a hint of nacho on the end. It's like the perfect amount of everything. I'm going to give this a 9.7.
Wow. Better than the Doritos.
Yep.
Wow.
Hot. Higher than the Doritos.
Hucking up 9.7s from deep. I like it.
They have an unbelievable crunch to them.
I bet the cheese is probably unbelievable.
It's so cheesy and good.
That's nice. Yeah. That's dangerous. I wish I could have some.
We would love to get a hockey sponsorship.
Oh, baby. Bring in the bank truck. Bring back up the bucket loader.
Let's just do it for free jockeys for life.
Yeah, just bring us a lifetime supply. And we want a fucking vending machine.
I want a neon sign.
And a vending machine. Unlimited lifetime supply. But I want to press the button. All right, I got another one here. Brisk Blood Orange.
Oh, wow.
I haven't had a Brisk iced tea in God knows how long.
Yeah.
Brisk iced tea are good. They're just, it's like a lot of sugar at once. And my favorite part is in Canada, that's like their version of iced tea. Like the other version of iced tea is like not, like doesn't exist to them.
Right.
Like when they order a tea, they order a Brisk.
A Brisk, baby.
I'll take a Brisk.
That's cool.
So now we got Blood Orange. I love a good Blood Orange, though. How shaken up this bottle is, I'll never know. Oh, there we go. That's how you know you got a master at the hands of the wheel here. Very Blood Orange. Kind of smells like orange soda.
Okay.
Oh, that's good. That's really good. It doesn't have like a carbonation, so it's like flat.
Right.
So it's kind of got that brisk sort of texture. And then it's just like pure blood orange soda. Yeah. Oh, God. This thing has probably got, 90 grams of sugar?
Yeah, it's going to have your day's worth.
Yeah, it's definitely going to have your daily value in a bottle. Unbelievable. If I could chug this and play video games, I would. And not gain weight, I would. I'd give it a 9.5. This is actually really good.
Nice.
Kills me to put this down. Any more snacks?
Yeah, I got one more. It's the actress Vanessa Hudgens has a new line of water out called Cali Water. Okay?
Unreal.
And here, this is what it looks like. There's two flavors, cactus water, ginger lime, and cactus water. Watermelon.
Now, are they from cactus water? Is that how they get it? Or is that just a name?
No, I think they get it from cactus. Organic blue agave,
I like it.
So we're going to review it.
Some people don't know if you're lost in a desert. Cactus, great source of H2O.
All right. Here's the first one, the ginger lime.
Ooh, I bet that tastes good.
Smells really good.
You like lime? I love lime.
Oh, wow. That's good. It's a little sweet. All right.
Is it H2O or does it have caffeine in it?
No caffeine. It's water with a little bit of sugar. But it's just like water.
Bubbly?
Not bubbly. But the flavor is really great.
I fucks with that. So making mixed drinks with that would probably taste pretty awesome.
Yeah, and that's so funny you said that. That's what it says too on the can. It's great as a mixer.
Oh yeah. They know their market.
Yep. So I'm gonna give it a 9.2.
Hey, Cali
Water. Let's go.
You gonna try the other one?
I tried it the other day. It's really good. Yeah. The flavors are on point.
That's unreal. For sure. When will those Cali Waters be making it east?
I'm not sure.
A little abandoned area called VT, Vermont.
Can we get some of that up to Vermont?
How much Cali cactus water gets east?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, for all of us here at Channel 4 News, I'm Ron Burgundy. You stay classy, San Diego.
And thanks for stopping by.